Welcome to Unacademy Neet English. I'm your biology educator Ambika Sharma. Hope you guys are doing very well and hope you people are following your 21 days challenge. If you have seen that video, very good. Otherwise, do check it on Unacademy Neet English channel and make sure you follow that. So students, till your Neet 2025, I'm going to come up like this. I'm going to share tips and tricks with you all. I'm going to provide you the strategy so that you study sincerely, so that you stay motivated, right? So I am here with you all in this journey. Okay, so today the topic is very important and interesting, and that is the how to read the NCERT. Yes, I know you all know that ultimately paper will come from NCERT. We have to read the NCERT, but still students are not able to score 360 out of 360, right? Despite knowing that paper will come from NCERT, you are not able to score full house. Why is it so? Because you don't know how to read the NCERT effectively. And why NCERT is important? Because the National Testing Agency, right, they take this NEET examination, they conduct this NEET examination, and they made it very clear that they are going to ask the questions from NCERT only. So 100 questions from biology, they'll come in your NEET paper, and 90 questions you have to attempt. So you guys can say out of that, 100 questions, you can say all the 100 will come from NCERT, or at least 90, 95 will come from NCERT. That's what you need to keep in your mind. Okay. So the best thing and the most important thing is this. So in this video today, that is what we are going to discuss. So make sure the points that I'm going to discuss with you all, you follow that, because ultimately it is the NCERT which is going to be a game changer for all of you. Okay, and that NCERT, right, not just for the biology, for the chemistry also you need NCERT, right? For physics, yes, there are some theoretical questions that will directly come from NCERT, but yeah, still for the physics you should have that concept clarity first. You need to practice the question, then you need to focus on the NCERT. Okay, so should we directly start with the NCERT? The answer is big no. Okay, the answer is big no. Why? Let's talk about the chapter cell cycle and cell division. I'll give you this example. Let's take the chapter cell cycle and cell division. Right, before attending the lecture, if you think you will directly read it from NCERT, is it going to be helpful? No. You should know about that topic first, and then when you will read it from NCERT, that will be helpful. Otherwise, if you think that I will directly read from NCERT, I'll start the self-study, I'm not going to follow any teacher, I'll directly read the chapter and then I will make notes as per PYQs, it is not going to be helpful, because the actual thing is we have to decode NCERT. It's about decoding NCERT. In each and every line of NCERT, there is a question, bache, and they can pick up the words and then they can relate it, right? They can relate it with another word given in NCERT, and accordingly they are going to ask the questions. So the most important thing that you need to take care is this: you have to read the decode the NCERT. Okay, so the very first thing that you have to take care is that you attend the lecture, right, you make the notes, and then you go for the NCERT reading. Okay, and it's not mandatory that you have to highlight everything, right? Do not highlight everything written in NCERT. I have seen the books of many students, right? They highlight everything with different markers. It is not going to help you at all. It is literally not going to help you at all. We highlight something when we, when we consider that point important, right? When we consider that question is going to come in our examination. So do not highlight everything. You have to highlight the important things. But now, ma'am, how to decide? So firstly, come to this part. You should attend the lecture, then make the notes, right, as per your understanding, and then go for the NCERT. And obviously students, we do not have that much time that we can, firstly attend lecture, then we can make notes, then we read NCERT, then we again make notes. No. So first thing is your teacher, right? Teacher selection should be proper here. Yes, your teacher selection should be proper here, because if your teacher, while teaching a chapter, if that teacher is covering the NCERT, if the teacher is highlighting the NCERT, if the teacher is marking the important things, then it will be helpful for you. So this is what you have to do. So do not highlight everything on the NCERT. Firstly, attend the lecture, make the notes. Definitely your teacher is going to tell you which statement is important, which PYQ is important, and as per that, when you read the NCERT, when you read it for the first time, do not highlight anything. But when you read the NCERT for the second time, then start highlighting the important points. And majorly, you should highlight PYQs with a fixed marker. Let's say if you are using green marker, right? Then for complete NCERT, then for complete NCERT, for all the chapters for class 11, 12, mark all the PYQs with that green marker only. Why? Because after some time, when you will, you know, revise that chapter, when you will look at that green lines, right, green highlighted lines, right, it will give you, right, your brain will perceive it in that way, that it is a previous year question, it is a previous year question. So in that way, obviously you are revising your NCERT, you are revising PYQs as well. Okay, and now there are some other important lines or important words. Let's say directly, right, directly NTA didn't ask it in the paper, but you believe that is important, right, your teacher is telling that is important. So for that particular word, use a different marker. Use a different marker. It can be a word, it can be a line. Okay, but please make sure that you follow the, you use same kind of markers throughout, right? No doubt you can use different markers also, that is your choice. But if you will see, I have a pattern, right? I follow that pattern, right? Obviously that is going to be easy for me. Let's say I have a routine, I know I have to get up early in the morning, okay, then I have to do this, do that. My brain is clear about it. Without any effort, my brain will be like, get up, do this. That's it, that's all. It's the habit, you know, our brain, it's the tendency of our brain. It makes everything easy. So now let's say, if you start highlighting every PYQ, previous year question statement, with a green marker, whenever you will revise your NCERT, whenever you will read that chapter, right, you will get that stimulus. It's a PYQ. In that way, you will retain that things for a longer time. So that's why I'm saying, be specific. Be specific here, right? Take care of it. And yes, if you believe that there is a topic your teacher is discussing, it is as per NCERT and some extra points are there, yes, you can use the sticky notes, right, in your NCERT itself. But please make sure one thing, that it should not, it should written properly, right? The clutter should not be there. It should be nicely presented there. Please take care of that, because it is not like that you are going to revise the NCERT just once. You have to revise this book again and again, so the clarity should be there. Now with one example, let's say this, obviously it is from your NCERT. Here they have given an information: DNA as an acidic substance present in the nucleus was first identified by Frederick Mischer in 1869. Guys, from this single line, they have asked many questions in different ways. So while reading the NCERT, make sure that you do not watch TV, or you should be attentive, in simple words. So first of all, if I have to make the notes, right, and if I have to make the notes, that doesn't mean that I will write the complete statement. Let me tell you, if I have to highlight it, what will I do? I'll show you. If I have to highlight DNA acidic substance, though it should be there in your mind, but still, if you are knowing it for the first time, highlight it. Okay, and Frederick Mischer, 1869. These three are the important things here. So if I have to make the notes, what will I do? What will I do? Let me tell you. DNA acidic. Now, because you will attend lecture, your teacher is going to tell you, because of the presence of that phosphoric acid, it is acidic. Okay, who discovered it? Frederick Mischer. Year 1869. That's it, that's all. I'm not going to write that complete statement. My notes are going to be like this. Right? Honestly, my notes are going to be like this. Okay, and that is something that I will use for the revision students. This is the point that you need to take here. So, he named it nuclein. Okay, so now what? Frederick Mischer discovered it in 1869. I'll write the word nuclein. Simple. He called it as nuclein. So due to technical limitation, it was very difficult to do this and that. So in 1953, James Watson and Francis Crick, based on the X-ray diffraction data produced by Morris Wilkin and Rosalind Franklin, they proposed a double helical model. Now, in my notes, what will I write? Simple. Double helical model. 1953, Watson and Crick. Method that they are used, your technique, X-ray crystallography or diffraction. Your teacher will tell you that X-ray diffraction is also known as X-ray crystallography, right? Morris Wilkin and Rosalind Franklin, their data, like this. Simple. simple, short and simple. So you people look for such books, that the books where we get the pointers. But you have to read NCERT by yourself. You have to revise it again and again. Then you can make your notes in this form, na? So basically from the NCERT, after attending the lecture, we have to make the notes. So if your teacher is highlighting that, that will be really helpful. So make sure, like whosoever you select for your biology, they follow this thing. They follow this thing, right? So notes should be there, and they should be in points, right? No paragraph, students. No need to write big paragraphs. Notes should actually be the short notes like this. Like this, no need for paragraphs, no paragraphs. Wherever required, make the flow charts. Make the flow charts, diagrams. You are not even allowed to skip the diagrams. Let me tell you how. So this is the one part I gave you an idea. So while reading the NCERT, wherever they have given something in bold, right, you should know the meaning of that. You should know the meaning of that. Now, let's say it's a previous year statement. I'll highlight it with this particular marker. If there is another previous year statement, I'll highlight it with the same marker. With the same marker like this. So, it's not mandatory that you have to highlight everything. You just need to pick up the important things. Now, let's say from the same chapter, there is another topic, transcription. So, how to read that transcription? Obviously, first of all, your lecture. And then, here you need the flowcharts. So, avoid writing paragraphs, go for the short notes, go for the flowcharts wherever required, because from that flowcharts, right, from each and every step here, the question can come. So this is one way. Now, diagrams, you are not even allowed to skip even a single diagram, even there, write this description. Okay, see, fascicle is known as muscle bundle, no doubt here also it is written, but sometimes simply revising the diagram can help you to remember that, and you get the question. Muscle fiber, muscle cells, then sarcolemma, blood capillary. So guys, first, whenever you have the diagram and you have the space in the NCERT, muscle fiber, you can add that points there. Anatomical unit of muscle, whatever extra points your teacher has mentioned related to the topic, you can mark it there in your book itself. You can name your diagram like this, but make sure you do not miss even a single word from the description. Now, when it comes to the tables, are we allowed to skip it? Not at all. You have to write each and every table given in NCERT is important. The question will come from these tables. So you are not allowed to miss it. So once there was a question from this part, GLUT4. So many students were like, it is out of NCERT, but it was there from the table itself. Right. So see, now one more example I'll give here, like trypsin. We know that digestion and absorption is deleted from our syllabus, but still trypsin is written here. So they can ask you the question. So at least you should know their role. So whatever is written in NCERT, you need to know their meaning, their function, and if it is related to any other chapter, you should know how to correlate that. So this is the right way to read the NCERT. So the very first way, if I have to summarize, attend the lecture, make the notes. If your teacher, while teaching you, is including your NCERT, that is perfect. That is perfect, because in your notes itself, you will get everything from NCERT. Then read the NCERT once. Do not highlight it when you are reading it for the first time. Then students, read it twice, right? And then start highlighting it. So no need to highlight each and every line, each and every word, the on like this. Highlight the important points. So for the PYQs, use a specific marker, right? For the important lines which you believe from where the question can come, use that different marker. So in this way, you have to read the NCERT and. For quick revision of NCERT, it is the summary part that you can follow. Let's say today, I'm teaching you molecular basis of inheritance, but you want to revise something from class 11th. You don't have time. You have less time. What will you do? You will pick up your notes and you can pick up the summary of that particular chapter for your quick recall. So that's the best way to read the NCERT. From each and every line, right? We have to pick up the question, right, bache? So here, see, this is what they have given. The principle of complementarity governs the process of transcription. What is transcription? mRNA will form from DNA. So except the adenosine complements now forms base pair with uracil instead of thymine. So from this simple line, what you guys should know? When you are reading adenosine, you should know they are talking about a nucleoside, not a nitrogenous base. That is the clarity that you need to get 360 out of 360. Then it is going to pair with uracil instead of thymine. uracil is a nitrogenous base which is only there in the RNA. So from this line, in different ways they can ask the question. So the concept clarity is important, then the flow chart for the quick revision of that. So I hope you find this information useful. If there is any doubt related to that, you can tell me. So you know that, guys, in the same way I'm teaching you people in your Phoenix Pro batch, and this batch is amazing because this is the last live batch for the NEET 2025 aspirants. Yes, but this batch is also amazing because you will get an access to the special rankers group online batch, and that is going to boost your score for sure. Moreover, mentorship sessions by educators, right? And you people would get enrolled in the All India Test Series with All India Rank Predictor. So you just need to pay, 5999. That's it, that's all. And you will have the access of all that features. So this amazing team is teaching you there. And if you will attend my biology classes there, students, so yes, I even upload the NCRT there, right? I even discuss the things from the NCRT. I highlight the NCRT in the live class itself. So whatever extra you need for the clarity of that topic, and when it comes to NCRT, it is also highlighted there. So ultimately, that one lecture will be more than sufficient to understand each and everything related to that topic, including PYQs. So without wasting any time, right, join this batch ASAP. We are discussing the human physiology, right? If you will join in this particular month, still it will be effective for you. If you will join in September, then there will be more backlogs. So start your preparation now so that in Phoenix Pro batch, we can finish your syllabus in 6 months, that is till 31st of January. So take care of that, students. So if there is any other topic that you people want me to cater, do let me know in the comment section. And if there is any specific chapter that you want me to start, you can tell me. You know that tomorrow, right, at 11 a.m. I will be taking the part two of this particular chapter, that is biological classification. Okay, I am going to take the part two of this biological classification and we are going to finish it. So quickly like this session, right, bache, and see you all tomorrow at 11. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Thank you so much.